So I'm running to Tesco's because I didn't buy sugar. I thought we had sugar in the house and they close at 10 and it's 46.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel and welcome to Cooking with Timmy. So I saw online this week a lot of people going crazy about this sprinkle cake. And I'm not here to comment on, you know, the whole drama. People can do what they want in terms of the cake. Like, people can buy it. I was actually going to buy one, but I just didn't because I wasn't sure I was going to get it to my house. People can not buy it. People think it's expensive, whatever. But I saw a few clips yesterday of people who had ordered cakes, the sprinkle cake, and they had received absolute trash. Let's just look at them together. This is cake one. I don't understand. I don't understand what went wrong here. This is cake number 2. I just thought, it's actually not that hard to make one of these cakes. I thought I would just make a video showing you guys how to make the cake. It's pretty simple. You don't need that many ingredients. Obviously, it's a pandemic. Anyway, it's a pandemic, but I just feel like you can get these ingredients from Tesco's. I got all of mine today, and if not, ask your mum. It's really easy to make. It takes about 45 minutes all in, including baking, about 50 minutes prep time, 25 minutes to 30 minutes in the oven, and then you let it cool down, put the icing on. So it's pretty quick, and let's get to baking. In terms of ingredients, you guys are going to need 300 grams of butter, 300 grams of sugar, 300 grams of self-raising flour, 5 large eggs, 95 ml of milk, 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence, 400 grams of icing, sugar, 8 teaspoons of milk, and 50 grams of sprinkles. And that is it. So, let me take you through the steps. Step 1, you're going to need to preheat your oven. I never used to do this, so I used to think, who literally cares? But actually, it's better to put the cake into a hot oven so it starts to cook straight away rather than dropping it in and then letting it kind of sit in there and then rise later. So, just preheat it. It says gas mark 3, I did gas mark 4 and it worked for me, so just do gas mark 4, but obviously know your oven. Ours is oldish, so it's not like brand new. So we do gas mark 4, or you can do 160 degrees or 350 degrees Fahrenheit if you are watching this from America, and if you are, hey y'all. Next, we'll align your greaseproof baking tray. I have these trays. They were £2 from Tesco, so like they're pretty cheap. If you haven't got a tray bake, I'm just doing it because this was what was in the trend on Twitter. If you don't have a tray bake, then you can actually just buy the smaller ones or just use an actual metal tin, it'll be fine. Line it with greaseproof paper, or if you're like me, you can just butter it up. It's easier. Just don't use too much butter, spread it across evenly. You kind of want to cover it so that your tray gets spread out nicely, and then you can just use that instead of greaseproof paper, because we never have greaseproof paper in this house. Don't know why, but we just don't. So next up, we're going to cream the butter and the sugar. Now, to make sure you have a light and spongy cake. The dog is excited by the sound of cake. To make sure you have a light and spongy cake, make sure you have your butter at room temperature. So if you have it in the fridge, it's not going to work. And don't be stupid like me when I was in year 10 in food tech and put it in the microwave, because it will just get all like melty and ugly. Let it cool for about 25 minutes outside to get to room temperature, or however long it takes to touch it and feel, and then use that with your sugar. So your 300 grams of butter with your 300 grams of sugar, cream it together till it's nice and smooth. If you have a Kenwood and you're bougie, great for you, use that. If you have a whisk, use that. If you've got a spoon or a spatula and that's all you've got, like I did when I made this last time, then just beat it with a spoon. Cream it until it's light and fluffy. Don't over cream it because it will actually start to curd and then break down and it'll make the cake a bit weird. So just do it gently, have it on a medium speed until it gets light. You'll see in the rest of the video. So once you've creamed the butter and sugar together and it's all light and fluffy, then you want to add your eggs in gradually. Add them in one by one and then mix them in so you get a nice smooth mixture. If you pour it in at once, it might get too liquidy and get a bit gloopy. So just add it one by one and mix it in gradually so it's nice and even. Once you've added your eggs into the sugar and butter mix, you want to add your flour in now and do it gradually, so about 2 tablespoons at a time, so you can mix it in and get a nice consistency of batter. 2 tablespoons is quite long, but I actually would recommend doing it properly because it just means it comes out a better consistency. If you want to risk it and have a terrible cake, then do so. But I'm going to do it 2 tablespoons at a time. And also make sure you sieve your flour through. It just makes it come through as the cake. I can't remember why, but I think from food tech, it adds more air into the cake, so it will rise better. There you go, memory. I've got an A star, so. Once that's done, you want to add in your milk and your vanilla extract. So 95 milliliters of milk and a teaspoon of vanilla extract, or however strong you like it. And as a quick side, add your milk in half at a time. So add half of the 95 ml in, mix it in so it's smooth, and then add the rest in. Thank you. And that's the body of the cake. So you've now made the batter, and you're going to pour that into your either butter lined tray like mine or your greaseproof paper lined tray, and then put that into the oven that you've preheated at gas mark 4 for 25 to 30 minutes. Also, make sure you spread out your cake evenly within your tray or tin, whatever you're using, so that it's evenly spread and will rise evenly. You don't want a lopsided cake that comes out looking like the ghost of Christmas past. Like, just make sure you sort it out and it looks nice and flat. You can use your spoon to flatten it out, or you can kind of just move the batter around, whatever works for you, get it flat, and then put it into the oven. Cake is out of the oven now, it's fully cooked. I took it out at about 30 minutes, so I put it back in for 5 more minutes. I didn't have a toothpick, which is what I normally use to just poke it through to the bottom to see that it's dry all the way through, so I just kind of stabbed it with a fork. Don't do that, get a toothpick or get something that you can use to check that it's dry at the bottom. As you can see, there are a few holes in the cake where I used the fork, but it doesn't really matter, we're covering it in icing anyway and it'll kind of fill the hole, so it's fine. It's about 12:15 now, so I'm gonna go to bed and I'm gonna go watch a film. I don't sleep till like 3 most nights. I'm gonna watch a film and then I'm gonna let it cool overnight. I'll see you guys tomorrow for the final part of the cake, which is covering with icing and sprinkles. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Morning guys, welcome back. I have my icing sugar. I went to Tesco this morning at 8 a.m. I was freaking out because I thought they didn't have any in stock, but I asked someone and it was actually in a different aisle. So I've got it. I'm gonna make the icing for the cake now. You're then going to need to weigh out 400 grams of icing sugar and then add 4 teaspoons of milk, stir it in, and then add the remaining 4 and then stir that in until you get the consistency. Now, depending on how thick you like your icing, you can add more or less, and then we're going to do the food colouring. So now at the food colouring, decide what colour you want. You can do green, you can do purple. The sandwiches are normally pink and blue. I'm going to do blue today. Just asked my mum and sister, we went for blue. So add 1 cap of the food colouring and just keep going through, get the colour you want. Don't put loads in because it can get really strong and then you have a colour you don't want and you can't go back, so just be careful. Once you've got your icing made, get your cake out of the oven where it's been cooling and pour your icing into the centre, and then I just rotate the base of the cake so it spreads around, and then top up the bits that have gaps in, and then let the bubbles pop on the icing, and then get your sprinkles and just go to town. So I normally just sprinkle as many as I want or until I can't see as much icing as I did at the start. Obviously, depending on your taste or how you want it to look, you can do whatever. So this is how I'm going to sprinkle mine. So that's it, that's how you make a sprinkle cake. It's nice and simple, as you guys can see, very easy. Comes out nice and spongy, it's great room temperature or heated up with some ice cream. Whatever you like, go ahead and do it. It's good. No, it's really good. They've come to some. So you guys can believe I'm not lying. Don't be shy, put some more. Don't look at the camera.
Of course you ate it like that.
4 out of 10 maybe, the other one's well. I'm joking, it's nice, I'm joking, it's very, very good. Actually exquisite in the taste of my mouth, and the texture is really fluffy and just delicious. It just melts in your mouth as you eat it.
Woo!
I did not pay him to say that, guys. Thanks for watching, and
that's why he keeps on looking to the side.
My Instagram is underscore, but that's my time.
Okay, see you guys next video. Goodbye!